thank you for your patience. We're just about to begin. Before we do, I'd like to welcome you on behalf of our students tonight and our drama department. They're so excited to be able to present to you this play. I want to remind you a couple things. If you need the restrooms, they're in the back in the foyer there. Number two, if you have your cell phone on, put it to silent, buzz, or off would help. And I think I had a third thing on here. Oh, if you have any room, if you could push in a little bit. I know there's still some people that are kind of waiting in the wings. So if you have any room, kind of get close to those neighbors of yours so other people can get seated. Okay. Well, before I pray, I'd like to present something special first that Mrs. Spoelstra doesn't know about. But we, one of our staff members wrote the author of the play, and she wanted to thank you, and I'm going to read her letter to you, Esther, and to the children. Dear Esther and the children of Santa Clara Christian School, I understand that tonight you'll be presenting Acorns to Oaks for your family and friends. I'm so excited for all of you. It's such a joy to know that you are using your God-given gifts and talents to glorify the Lord, especially during this precious Easter season. Esther, please know I'll be praying for you and your children tonight. I'm thanking God in advance for all he will do through your presentation.
Thank you.
To God be the glory. Joyfully, Celeste Flagstaff.
Wow.
So why don't we begin with just a short word of prayer, praying for our children. Lord, thank you so much for the opportunity to see your good news presented through children. Lord, it always reminds us that it takes a child's heart to understand what you're trying to accomplish in our lives. Lord, bless our evening and all that we do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
gone up to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit to live in us and to be our leader. When we follow the leader, good things called the fruit of the Spirit can be seen in our actions and words. So come on, let's keep in step with the Spirit.
Galatians our harvest.
Oh, I'm afraid you've only got one more day.
One day? What are you talking about, Mrs. McDonald?
I heard on the radio 20 minutes ago. Can you get it?
They're still talking about it.
Turn it on again.
You know, Alfred, the last construction you built was supposed to paint the barn. It ended up painting the cows instead.
But this one really works. It's all testing ready to go. Here it is. My latest invention. It slices, dices, packs everything into a bale.
Yeah.
go to the North Fork. They'll let us here, but I supervise the plant.
All right, Meg, the North Fork it is.
Mr. McDonald! Mr. McDonald! Bad news! Bad news from the North Fork!
What bad news is she talking about, Meg?
I don't know, sir. That's Pat, my assistant.
What's the bad news, Pat?
The crops, Mr. McDonald. They've withered and died. We planted them several times in back, but they just never took root.
I was afraid of this. Did you find many rocks in the soil, Pat?
Yes, sir. Lots of rocks and weeds, too. And whenever we tried putting down new seeds, these birds flew down and ate them up.
This is exactly what happens when you don't cultivate the soil.
Cultivate? What's that?
Cultivate means preparing the soil for planting, getting rid of anything that might be in the way of seeds that are trying to grow. Do you cultivate the soil, Meg?
No, we plow. Who said anything about cultivate?
As a matter of fact, some had a lot to say. His name was Jesus, and he knew more about sowing and reaping than any farmer who ever lived. He told his friends a story about things. I think it's something you need to hear.
Do something! The birds are gonna eat the crop!
what?
Enough flitting around. Let's start on rolling.
Time to beat on some sea. What do you say, Lark?
I'm scratching and snatching, Maggie. But
where's the sea?
Sorry, ladies, but this is good soil. The seeds have already taken root and grown. You'll have to find some poor soil somewhere else.
Right. Let's fly this coop, Robin.
I should say. What inhospitality? Won't you say, Lark?
We'll never attempt a lunch with the teacher again, Maggie.
Beware, 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 be wise. So listen and
Hey, Alfred, I'm sorry to listen to those guys. I didn't really believe the stories they were telling everybody.
That's okay, Pat.
Man, we're never going to get this harvest done on time. We're chasing birds and killing weeds. Now the weather's starting to cloud up. Is the soil finally good enough?
Okay, there's still one problem with the soil. I can see the rocks and stones right where I stand.
Rocks? In this soil? It's as flat as it can be. I don't see any rock in this soil.
Rocks come in many shapes and sizes, Ned. They can be found in a closed mine and a hardened heart. Nothing can grow that isn't over.
Hard times would help. me go, Mr. McDonald. But I'm learning I can't do everything on my own. So we're going to have to work together, right?
Well, yes, that is right. It's the way we were created, Meg. God knew that we'd try and fail on our own. But he loved us so much he gave us a way back to him. That way is Jesus Christ. Jesus is where Caesar took will stay planted, take root, and grow to bear eternal fruit. That's not man's way, that's God's way.
How do I make that my way?
All you have to do is ask.
Thank you.
sure seems a lot different now. It's sure a lot better than doing everything on my own.
The Lord will be with you every step of the way, Meg, and so will all of your brothers and sisters.
That's awesome. But even with all of us working together, we're not going to get this harvest done. It's just a few minutes till sundown, and we got all those fields in front of us.
I've really not been working on that. It might help. Will you go get that to me, Pat?
Sure thing.
Of course they may not work, though. You don't have to use them if you don't want to, Meg.
Alfred, I'm really sorry for all the times I made fun of you and your inventions. I guess I was just jealous because you were so smart. And I would love to see what you've been working on.
Yeah, just give us time to take cover. Here it is. Wow, what are those?
I call them the Super Ram Multi-Drive Turbo Harvester. Batteries not included.
How does it work?
Well, when I've looked at all those fields, I know they're right for harvest. So if all of you will help me pass around the turbo harvester, we'll collect the biggest harvest we've ever had.
And remember, this harvest is just the beginning. Jesus has called us all to spread the seed of his love to every person in every land. Now that will be a harvest. The farmhands are ready, Mr. McDonald.
They sure are. I declare I've never seen so many acorns turn to oak so quickly. Give them their order, Meg.
Yes, sir. It's harvest time.
The harvest is plentiful, the workers are few, and the Lord is so many people who need to know you. Oh, here I am, Lord, send me. Yes, here I am, Lord, send me. Both in our eyes, the fields are ripe, there's so many lives that need to know Christ. Thank you.
back on. Okay, now, one more time for the whole crowd. One of our productions, I'm always surprised that I'm surprised. Because your children are just absolutely amazing. You guys did an incredible job. Yeah. But of course, we know that they were led strongly by Mrs. Sposal. Please come forward.
This production won't happen without all the help of these wonderful people. Of course, I can only teach them the songs, but if we don't have the movements, it's gonna be the most boring show. So let's give Miss Stacy a hand! Also, we have these costumes for the children that has worked. Mrs. Amstetter, she is our costume lady. She did all this. All the hard work. All the labor of love. And also, all these wonderful sets that we have. Mrs. Borges and Mr. Borges, please come up here. Stage, we don't have any design for it. So we would have Mrs. Gonzalez come up, our stage designer. And thank you to my wonderful husband who's been very supportive of my ministry in the school, and with Mr. Borges helping set up all this wonderful props. Please come up, Mr. Sposal. And also, all this hard work from our tech director, Pastor Brooke. He made all the sounds happen, the lights, all the programs, the feature, everything. Without all these gifted people, who's just wanting to give everything back to the Lord for all the talents that He has given them, it will not happen. And of course, we have parent volunteers that have helped us tremendously. Can we ask Mrs. Parks to come up, one of our school artists? Once again, let's give them all a big round of applause.
Thank you, Mrs. Sposal. I just wanted to announce inside of your bulletin flyer, one of the things that's so important to us on this Easter weekend is that we would celebrate the life of Jesus. And our church and our school is part of that, of course. If we have a festival on Saturday that we would like to, I would like to personally invite you to, and bring these children with you, but also your neighbors and friends. Show them your school, your children's school, and then just come on out. Everything is free, and it's just an incredible time. And then as well, if you do not have a home church, I would love to invite you to our church, which will be meeting on the field, the school field, on Easter morning at 10 o'clock. And we would love to have you come and join us for Easter service. So I want to make those announcements to you. And I want us to close in prayer. Okay. One more announcement.
Yes. Tomorrow, they will need this place the way it is. So parents, we need your help.
after the show, if you could help us out, put this back in the place where we found it. We're gonna tell you later, but we need all of you to help us.
So yeah, they're actually having a Good Friday service here in 24 hours, and all of the barn and everything's got to go. So if you can stay behind and help us with that, that would be fantastic. So let's go ahead and thank you again, everyone who helped. Thank you, children, for the wonderful job you did tonight. Let's go ahead and pray. Lord, we are so thankful for the message of the Word of God that grows in our hearts. And Lord, we open our lives to you tonight, that you would plant the seed of your life in us, and that we grow strong, in spite of the birds, in spite of the weeds, in spite of the rocky soil, that we would hide your word in our heart and know you better. Thank you so much for your work in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much. If you're a parent, please come and collect your child up here. We're not going to release them, so please come forward and grab them. And the rest of you, please feel free to help us tear down and also take some pictures with them. Thank you. God bless you.